Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're talking about October favorites, and I have quite a few things that I got this month, so if my husband is watching, please click away. Hi guys, it's been a minute since the initial filming of this video, so I intended for this to go up like towards the end of October, and then that didn't happen because I had a 1 month old. And then it didn't get up in November either, and now it's almost New Year's. So I'm just gonna call this my fall favorites, because this is just gonna end up being all sorts of stuff that was from fall, even though it was initially supposed to be October favorites. So I'm gonna add two more things at the end of the video, so stay tuned. You may have noticed, if you look at my channel, that it's been a minute since I've uploaded. My last upload was about my baby shower, and since then, I've actually had my baby, so belly is all gone. She's out in the world, and she's doing great. She's actually out on a walk with her dad right now. So while they're out on a walk, I'm gonna talk about some of the fun things that I got this month. I don't know, maybe I'm just doing more online shopping because I'm just sitting around and can't do anything else because of, you know, nursing. Like, a lot of this stuff is like art related, which is why I wanted to share it. So let's just get into it. So these first things that I got are some art supplies, and they're things that have been on my wish list for a really long time. And I don't know if you guys are similar in the way you shop, but for me, when I shop and I have something that I want to buy, oftentimes what I'll do is I'll move it, like if it's not an immediate necessity, I'll move it into my cart, and then when I need to buy something, I'll move it back out, because then it like adds too much to the price, and then it'll be moved back in and out of my cart for sometimes years. So this is one of those things that has been moved in and out of my cart for years, and it is the Fine Tech metallic watercolor set. I've heard a lot of good things about these watercolors, and I'm really excited to start incorporating these into my illustrations. All right, the next thing is kind of related to the metallic element and as in terms of art supplies, but I got some gold leaf. You can't really see it because it's wrapped in tissue paper, because gold leaf is super thin and rips very easily. But I got gold leaf size adhesive, which, you know, you need adhesive to put it on your paper. And then this is basically a burnishing brush. So once you have the gold leaf on the artwork, and then, you know, you're ready to remove the excess, this is what you use to like remove that excess. So really excited to start using that for my artwork. Kind of in terms of like painting supplies, I got a new ceramic palette. This is an 18 well palette, and I wanted to get something like this because I had a really cheap plastic palette, and it had all sorts of little like circles and squares to mix your colors in, and like in theory that sounds really nice, but I just found it very limiting because I tend to like to mix all over my palette, like my mixing area. So in that sense it felt very limiting. And then aside from that, like the plastic doesn't clean very easily, so I wanted to get ceramic because I figured it would be easier to clean. So we'll see how this goes with this palette. And last, in terms of art supplies, I got these Artiza miniature brushes. They're detail liner spot and round brushes, and I'll show you the back because that has all the sizes that they have in this pack. Recently discovered not a new artist, but she is new to YouTube. And so she had posted a few videos and she came up in my recommended. Her name is Sibylline M. And she is an amazing gouache illustrator. And I noticed in her comments on her Instagram that she uses these brushes to get really fine details. And if you look at her YouTube, I'll link her YouTube and Instagram below because she is amazing. But she does really good detail work, and so I wanted to get some of these because I don't have small enough brushes like this to get that kind of fine detail, so I wanted to try these out. I got some merch from some of my favorite artists. You may know Furry Little Peach. If you don't, I'll link her YouTube channel below. But she just released a children's book. She actually had already released a children's book a couple years ago called Zoom. I got that one on Amazon. It's available. I think it's only like $11 in the US. And she recently released a new children's book called Bandits. And I got a copy and I'm very excited. You know, I wanted her children's books anyways, but well, especially because at the time they shipped from Australia, which this one I did have to get shipped from Australia, so it was a little bit more expensive in terms of children's books. But I really wanted to get her book Zoom before, but it was too expensive and I think it had already sold out, so I couldn't get it even if I wanted it. But now that I have a daughter, I have a better excuse to get this kind of stuff, like, you know. So I'm really excited to just read this with her and, you know, see how she likes it growing up. And I think she'll really enjoy the illustration style. It's amazing, really well done book. And just a cute little story, nothing too crazy. So really am excited about that. I bought a bunch of prints from Lee Alexson. Alexson? Alexson. Alexson. I don't know. I bought them from Lee. These are some of the prints that I got. Got a bunny and a frog. And then, let's see. I love this raccoon print. Like, this is kind of like this similar style to what I want to achieve in my artwork. It's just like very vibrant and a little bit more expressive and impressionistic. I'm kind of want to do something similar in terms of like style. And then I got this tiger print and then this snow leopard print. And those are all like, I think last runs from her shop. I'm really excited, especially for the raccoon, bunny, and the frog. I think I'm gonna hang those up in my daughter's nursery because I decorated her nursery in a forest theme. So I think having like those, you know, foresty woodland creatures would really go well with the theme. And the others I'll probably hang on my gallery wall, which I haven't put up any video of my gallery wall, but I might put up those videos on my second channel, which I will link below. And then the last thing I have to show you, I'm actually wearing right now. It is more art related. It's two t-shirts. One of them is this one. I think it's called the Mesa Design. It's from this company called Serengeti. And basically they are a very small t-shirt company, mostly. They do like t-shirts, a little bit of jewelry, stickers, and then like, you know, some other textiles and things like that. But mainly their shtick is t-shirts. I think they're really cool because all their t-shirt designs are focused around travel, which if we weren't in a pandemic, I would like to be traveling. I really do enjoy travel. And so I liked that first of all. So all of their t-shirts are like kind of a travel theme. And secondly, they partner with all artists all around the world. And those artists create designs for their t-shirts. And every time you buy one of those t-shirts, the artist that created the design gets royalties. So they get a percentage back from that sale. So I think it's really cool that they're supporting artists in that way. So this is the first design that I got. And then I mostly placed an order because they were offering a free gift with purchase. So they're offering a second free t-shirt, well, a long sleeve tee, for free if you place like an order of $30, which I'm pretty sure by the time this video is up, they'll be out of that free gift with purchase by now. But this is the second one that I got, which I thought was really cool. They have a lot of designs like these. This from this one artist, which I will put her Instagram up, but she does a lot of like really cosmic kind of designs. And so they're actually offering a bundle right now of her t-shirt designs, which I kind of want to get. So that's the second one, and I'm really excited about it. I can't wait to start making use of it. I also got these two stickers, which I thought was really cool. The design kind of goes together. So there's that one and this one, Chase Views. And then they sent a postcard. It's a Santorini postcard. And then they sent a ring. It's like a little airplane. So they sent this little airplane ring and was my order. So that was my Serengeti order. I'm really excited about it. I actually signed up to be a rep for them because of, you know, what they're doing with the whole, like, I mean, aside from the travel theme, also supporting the artists that they, that are making the designs for their t-shirt by getting royalties. So I signed up to be a rep for their company. So if you want to purchase anything from Serengeti, there is a offer code in the description for 20% off of your purchase. Hello, it's me again from the future. I think, right? I don't know. And it's too early. I can't figure out how time works. So one more thing that I wanted to add was this awesome, like water jar, like to rinse off your paintbrushes. I got it on Etsy from, I don't want to drop it, BNCA Pottery. And I just thought it was like such a cool little thing. I think a lot of ceramic art shops are making these now. Like probably not a lot in comparison to how many ceramic shops there are, but a fair number are making stuff like that now. I've been really interested in getting more of that, like awesome, that cool like ceramic artist supplies. I just think like it seems like they're really good quality, and I don't know, they're just pretty, so it's nice to have pretty things. And yeah, so this is really nice, highly recommend BNCA. And then let me show you the other thing that I got. Okay, the second thing that I got was the Sibling and Masseri collaboration sketch, like workbooks and, you know, watercolor books. So this is the regular watercolor book. It has the normal Masseri watercolor paper inserts, and it's just like such a beautiful cover by Sibling, which I had already mentioned earlier in the video. And then second is the workbook, which is actually really cool. If you're interested in like learning to paint or learning about gouache, I actually so far highly recommend it. Clearly I haven't gotten too far into the book, but having painted with acrylics and like taking a formal painting class, should I have closed that page too soon? Like I like that she gives you these exercises at the beginning to like start to learn how to handle your paints. To me, that just shows that it's going to be a really good workbook to learn from. And I like how she kind of like build up to fully finished paintings. You know, she'll break down some of these like step by step, and then she lets you figure out how the rest are supposed to be painted, and then you take what you learned throughout the workbook, and eventually you work up to fully finished paintings. So I think it's just really well done. So if you're interested in gouache, or if you are a fan of Sibling's work, I cannot recommend this enough. I think it's really great. And so this is the first thing I bought of Sibling's, and also the first Masseri, that's my daughter, the first Masseri anything that I've ever purchased. So very excited about that. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching this little video. I'm so excited to be like kind of filming again. I'm trying to get back into the groove of things. So hopefully I can stay regular, but I'll try my best. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.